Welcome to another of the video series covering various functions of the Reliance SCADA HMI system. Today, we are focusing on sending text messages via a GSM modem. You can use Reliance for both sending and receiving text messages. Thanks to this, we can develop an interactive monitoring and control system that can respond to a text message by sending a reply text message to the sender's phone number. Of course, the system may be secured by both enabling only some phone numbers and using a security code that can be part of the text message. The choice is up to the user. For example, text messages may contain information on a generated alarm or event, or any general information on the status of the visualized industrial process. They can also be sent as replies to incoming messages. To send a text message, an appropriate GSM modem with a SIM card inserted must be connected to the computer. If the modem has no physical serial interface, it is necessary to install a corresponding driver for it. In addition to the Reliance 4 system installed on the computer, you need to have a valid license for SMS driver. And sending text messages from Reliance's runtime environment using a GSM modem is exactly what we are going to show you in this simple video. It features an example project that was prepared in advance because of time reasons. In the visualization window, we have placed components which will help us enter and send the text of the message. We have created a script for sending the text message. We have defined tags and configured communication with the GSM modem. We'll also be using an access network camera to see the telephone to which the text message will be delivered. So, let's get started. In the Reliance design development environment, display components are placed in the visualization window. They will allow us to enter the recipient's telephone number and the text of the message. The third display will only be used to show the status of the sent message. We'll send the message by pressing this button. Just to show you the message is delivered successfully, an Nexus IP camera component is placed in the window. To watch the message being delivered live, there's a cell phone in front of the camera. In order for the message to be sent, tags and a script must be defined and linked to the respective components. In the device manager, three internal tags of type string are defined. A tag named send number is used to enter the recipient's phone number, and the send text tag enables us to enter the desired text. On the advanced page of both tags properties, the required number of string characters must be specified. The send number tag only needs 20 characters, and the send text tag should have at least 160 characters with respect to the length of the message. On the same page, the initial value option can also be activated. This option allows us to predefine, for example, a phone number that will be used for sending the message. This means we won't have to enter this number manually at runtime. The third tag defined via the device manager is a tag named send SMS result, which will allow us to display the status of the sent message. In the script manager, a simple event script with commands for sending the message is defined. The script must be linked to the button that will be used to send the message and connected to the logical computer via the project structure manager. The send SMS script provides the ability to send the text message to the phone number stored in the send number tag. The text of the message is stored in the send tags tag. First, we have to obtain the values of these tags by calling the rtagGetTagValue method and remove leading and trailing spaces using the trim function. The results are then assigned to the variables number and tags declared in the script with the dim statement. After that, we can call the rmodemGSMSendSMS method, which will pass the request for sending the message to SMS driver. The rmodemGSMSendSMS method accepts the phone number and the text of the message as parameters. The return value of the method is tested by the if statement. If the message is successfully passed to the driver to be sent, the method returns true and the text OK is written to the send SMS result tag. If an error occurs, the text error is written to this tag. Now, let's open the Project Structure Manager on the SMS page and configure the appropriate settings for the logical computer. We must activate the option for starting the communication driver and configure the other properties so that they correspond to the settings of the port. If the SIM card in the modem requires a PIN, it must be specified here. Next, depending on the telephone service provider, we must choose the number of the SMS service center. In the Communication Driver Manager, other options for SMS driver can be specified. Do not forget to have the driver licensed. In the visualization window, we must connect the displays to the corresponding tags. Also, we must connect the send message button to the script before we send the message. Here, we can see that the send SMS script will be run by pressing the left mouse button. Okay, now we are ready to type the text message. First, let's take the cell phone and put it in front of the camera. Good. Now we can enter the text of the message. This phone number has already been entered in the development environment. The status will be displayed once we send the message. Okay, let's send the message. The speed of the delivery depends on the telephone service provider. We can see right here on the camera that our text message has really been delivered. You can try out a demo application named SMS, which is available in the Demos folder upon the installation of the Reliance system, typically in the directory specified below.